Students, welcome back. So let us continue with the TCP/IP reference model. So in the previous video, I have just explained about the application layer and the transport layer. Now let us see the inter-network layer. Inter-network layer. So what this inter-network layer will do? So it allows host to inject packet into any network. So the main thing is it allows host to inject packets into any network. And here the protocol that used in inter-network layer is the IP. So this is IP address internet protocol and ICMP. So this IP is used. Why we are using the IP protocol in inter-network layer? So for proper delivery of the packet to the destination. So we have to reach the message to the destination. So to reach the message from source to destination, you need the IP address. So the network layer IP address you need. So this IP protocol is used for proper delivery of packet to the destination. Then what about this ICMP? This ICMP protocol is used for error reporting protocol. So it is used for the error reporting. Now coming to the last layer, that is, what is that last layer? The fourth one, network access layer. So the network access layer is also called as a data link plus physical layer. So the data link plus physical layer is called as network access layer. We are accessing the network. Okay, so just we are accessing the network. So to access the network, we need some data link and the physical layer support. So what this data link and physical layer will do? So the main functions that it's doing is error control. It is monitoring the error control, flow control, access control, and bit conversion. So these are the operations that this physical layer and the data link layer is doing. Bit conversion. So these are the two the remaining layers that are present in the TCP/IP reference model. So let me just give a simple explanation about this TCP/IP. Let me take this. Suppose here the sender is there, and here the receiver. Here the sender and the receiver are there. So let's take, this is the application. Next, transport, network, that is the inter-network, data link and physical. So what exactly these layers are doing the operations from sender to receiver? So here the sender is, the application layer is having the protocol HTTP. Along with HTTP protocol, the user is asking the request. Okay, means this is the user side, and this is, suppose this is the client and this is the server. So the client is requesting one message. So with the help of, along with HTTP protocol, a request message is passing. So when coming to the transport layer, this HTTP added with TCP/IP protocol plus HTTP along with request. Okay, next coming to the network. So when this transport is sending the message to the network is adding IP address to that message. IP, TCP/IP protocol along with HTTP and the request message. So then it comes to the data link layer. Now the data link layer is added with the protocol that is used in data link layer is Ethernet. Ethernet plus IP plus TCP plus HTTP and then request, the user client request, and the physical layer is sending the in the form of everything. This message is sending in the form of signals, so from sender to receiver. So the receiver is first, it takes the signals, so which is a physical link. So whenever it takes the signals, so these signals will be decrypted with Ethernet plus IP plus TCP plus HTTP along the request, along with request. So then this network, with the help of this Ethernet, it is identify the network, with the help of this IP, we identify the network of the receiver, IP, TCP plus HTTP along with request. Next, so with the help of the TCP, we finally find out the transport layer, that in the receiver side, TCP plus HTTP and the request. So finally, the user, the server side, we receive the message of HTTP and the request of the sender, the request of the client. So this is how the operations are passing from one layer to the another layer. So all these messages sent to transport with the help of the HTTP, and here with the help of TCP, IP, Ethernet, everything. Okay, so this is about the TCP IP reference model. Thank you.